Hello and welcome, my name is Coach Pav, and today I'm going to be discussing how you can win the War of the Scales. So this is one of my favourite topics to discuss, and there's a few reasons for that, but the biggest one is probably because so many of my clients, probably the majority of my clients, come to me and they tell me that along with their goals, be that ultra endurance stuff like Race Across America, Grand Fondos like the Maratona and or Mallorca 312, they also say that they want to lose some weight. And often it comes with something that says, and I know what I should be doing, but I'm just not losing the weight. And I'm going to go through today all of the tips and all of my expertise and my years as a coach and how to help you as an athlete lose that weight. So I'm going to start with the conflict in information. That's probably one of the biggest things. If you've been trying to lose some weight, I bet that you've been on the internet, you've Googled it, and you've been listening to so many different people, be them companies or businesses or influencers and stuff like that, about their best practices with losing weight. And they'll probably say they have one way in which you should lose weight. And you know, then you'll go to the next influencer or whoever, and they'll go, nope, you shouldn't be doing that. You should be doing this. Now, they're not necessarily wrong. That's the thing to remember, is that actually the reason they're doing that, there's two reasons. One is that they probably have had those results with some people, be that themselves or others. But ultimately, it's all anecdotal. And you shouldn't really listen too much or rely too much on anecdotal information, because we're all individual. It's the reason why scientific studies or sports science studies don't often get repeated, or have never, as far as I know, never really been repeated identically, because we are individual. Even in 4 months' time, you will be slightly different to who you were, be that because you've eaten differently, you've changed jobs, or you know, you've done different training, you've done some training. You are fundamentally constantly changing, and that has to be taken into account when you are trying to lose weight. And now, of course, the second reason why people are conflicting or really focused on one way is because they're probably trying to sell you something. Now, obviously, businesses, influencers, coaches, especially fat loss coaches or strength and conditioning coaches, some of them, they do want you to buy a product. And yes, some of these do work, but I do definitely feel like if you're just looking for information, try and find sources of unbiased information. Now, I'm going to say that coaches such as myself are a great source. Now, obviously, the caveat to that is, yes, I do want you to become a client, but you don't need to buy anything to use this information for you to lose weight. I absolutely am happy for you to use this information on your own to lose some weight. If you're having a problem, if you still haven't unsure, reach out to me. We can have a chat. 15 minute consultations are free. And if you do want to become a client, that's fantastic. But like I say, I'm not going to sell you any products. I've not got like a subscription fee where you can pay me a small amount of money that you need to in order to have my services. You either have a full coaching service with me, or you can use all the content that I put out. Absolutely fine. And a lot of coaches are like that. So I do think that always ask yourself, why is this content out there? Why are people doing it? Does it relate to me? And, you know, am I wise in actually listening to this? So another factor that I love, I always hear it is, you know, if you eat less, if the calories that you eat is less than the calories that you burn in a day, you will lose weight. Now, of course, fundamentally, bottom line is that you do need to eat less than you expend. But that's not actually how that works. You know, for example, if you were to eat nothing but McDonald's but still be burning, more than that, you know, you're not going to be healthy. And that's the biggest thing here, is that we don't really want to focus on losing weight in order to be healthy. We want to focus on being healthy in order to lose weight. When you switch that mindset, you're actually going to find that you're going to do a lot better. And besides, when we talk about actually calories in and out, it's that you actually do need to provide your body with the right micronutrients. And the micronutrients are the stuff that you get from plants, and they are going to help, you know, they're the oil in your car, whereas your macros, which are your fat and carbohydrates and sometimes protein, they're your fuel. And what you do need to be eating enough calories to lose that weight. Because if you start to starve yourself, that's when your body kind of goes, hey, you know what? I don't think that I'm going to get food. And therefore, you know, I might lose weight, but you know, you're probably going to just cannibalize your muscles and hold on to that fat, because your body wants to ensure that you are going to be able to survive. And it doesn't know that you're actually just going to, you're starving yourself to lose weight. So you reduce muscle mass because that's where you burn a lot of calories, and it holds on to fat because that's your fuel. The other factor about this is you're probably focused too much on losing weight. When we focus on losing weight so strongly, you create so much stress. And that stress is fundamentally not going to be, you know, create an environment in your body where your body's going to go, hey, you know what, I'm going to lose weight. And now we know this because we've adapted, and you know, to our new environment far quicker than our bodies have evolved. We know that we still are predisposed to behaviors in our DNA from when we were struggling to find food. I mean, it's only been several thousand, tens of thousands of years since we've had agriculture. It's not enough time to evolve. And agriculture, farming techniques, be that 10,000 years ago or modern intensive farming, that has given us enough food for any time of year. Most of us, of course, we're talking, not everybody has enough food. And the big issue with that is, while it's not an issue itself, that is that our bodies actually still don't really know that that's what's going to happen. And in a high stress situation, your body goes into this stasis where it tries to keep your weight at a certain point. And again, that's where you could cannibalize muscle over fat, because your body thinks, oh no, I'm not going to be able to eat soon. It's that same stress back, you know, many, many thousands of years ago. Our biggest stress, apart from being eaten or killed by an animal or a different tribe, was, well, will we get food? And when it's that simple, you know, your body just knows that it needs to hold on to this for like a long winter or anything. So you definitely have to create an environment where you're eating the right amount of the right foods in order to support that your body in terms of how it's oiled, but also that you're mentally in a great place, that your body feels safe and you're relaxed enough to be able to actually drop that weight. So of course you want some tips for caring less, and you know, go to my on my website, I'll have the full list, but here's some really obvious ones, right? Reducing stress, such as taking a bath, or you know, a short walk, meditating, practicing mindfulness or gratitude, making sure you prioritize sleep and getting extra sleep, or having a nap if you're tired during the day. Doing something for you, you know, taking time for yourself, wherever that is. Maybe you've got another hobby that you like doing, or spending time with family, go watch a movie, you know, chilling out, eating some good food. Just, we all have these ways in which we like to relax. It's just we tend to forget to do them, you know, and we get so caught up in our day-to-day that we actually, you know, forget to take time for ourselves. So definitely make sure you're utilizing those tips to relax. Now, another big one is called set point theory. Now, definitely check this out, but it's an interesting, and you know, makes a lot of sense, that our bodies have a set point weight at which it wants to always return to. And we know that our bodies have a homeostasis. They're always constantly trying to return to a certain state. Be that whether you're trying to, your body's trying to return fluids to the right amount, heartbeat, core temperature, stuff like that. Same as with weight. And you probably have heard of a time where someone has said to you, hey, I lost all this weight, and then all of it came back on. You know, it may have been you. Almost proof of the fact that set point theory and your body wanting to return, you can lose a lot of weight, especially if you crash diet, but ultimately you just end up going back on. And that happens because we crave food, or you know, like I said earlier, you're breaking down the muscle instead of fat, and then as soon as you start to eat a bit more, you build the muscle back up because you're training or whatever, but you know, you didn't actually lose the fat in the first place. So your body is going to constantly try to return you to this set weight. Now, the way in which we actually make sure that our bodies drop this set weight, or settled weight, I like to call it, is making sure that you are losing weight slowly. But when you get to around a certain percentage, now this is theorized at around 10%, but it will depend on how much weight you've got to lose. When you get to that 10% loss, rather than continuing to try to drop weight, hold it. And now, unfortunately, it's not as easy process, and you're gonna need probably 6 months. So you need 6 months to be able to hold that weight. 10% is still a lot of body weight to lose. But when you get there, 6 months, and then your body should have a new set point. And that's obviously a crucial factor, because then you can start to lose weight again. If it doesn't quite work out, your body's only going to go back up to the new set point weight and not the original one. And in that way, you should never really go back up to that weight. Unless, of course, you go completely off the rails and you eat a lot of food and you put your body weight up, and then you hold it for a long period of time, and then your body settles into that weight. Now, of course, the biggest problem to this is that actually, as human beings, we want instant gratification. And you're probably listening to this thinking, in 6 months? Yes, and it's 6 months you've got to hold it. That's without the loss of 10% body weight, which could potentially be three or more months in itself. And that's where you really do need to see weight loss as a long-term thing. If your mindset is going to be on the short term, you know, you're never going to lose that weight. That's the honest truth. That is that the honest truth is that you cannot expect these short-term gains. And if you do, and if you're promised this by other people, you know, you're probably going to spend your money. You might see those weight loss gains, and then as soon as you stop paying that money, your weight goes back up. And that's how they make money. ultimately, hopefully, you don't fall for too many of those. And if you do, then hopefully you buck the trend and you actually do keep the weight off. Unfortunately, you know, many of my clients come to me and they tell me I've spent thousands of pounds or dollars on nutritional supplements and stuff like that. And you know, maybe it's just returned back to your normal weight. So the last two things, as I wrap up, is that if you're a calorie counter, I do think that when you count calories, you are probably creating quite a lot of stress and too much focus on what you are eating as not the right thing. So while I do recommend to my clients that for 2 weeks when they change their nutrition, they do count the calories. 2 weeks is still a long time, but it's often that you don't have 2 weeks for the data, because you'll have days where you forget or you mess up or it's not quite right. 2 weeks should give you enough data to be able to work with a coach or nutritionist and go, hey, that you need to eat more fruit and vegetables, or actually your protein isn't quite right. And that's how I work with my clients. We do it for 2 weeks, and if we're seeing the right improvements, the weight is dropping off, then we stop calorie counting. And that way you reduce the stress. It's one less thing to do. It's a ball ache, isn't it, to calorie count, especially if you cook from home and you've got to list into the app all of the different things. I genuinely believe that calorie counting can have its place, but I don't think we should rely on it, because it creates too much stress. And as I've already talked about, stress is the last thing that your body needs when you're trying to lose weight. And the final thing before I wrap up, you eat healthy. Now, healthy is a word that isn't necessarily protected, and by that I mean that, you know, it can say it's healthy when actually it's not. I think the number one thing for me is that if it says healthy on the label, you're already eating the wrong food if you want to lose weight. Try to buy food that doesn't have a label in the first place, and then you pretty much can't go wrong. Like, if you are eating foods solely that have no label, then over a certain period of time, you will lose weight. I don't see how you couldn't do that. Of course, only human, and I work with my clients, and we had this commitment level that I talk about, whereby I actually am not gonna give them shit for having a beer or a takeout every now and again, because that is part of being human. And the last thing I want is for any of my athletes to go so focused on their training and nutrition that 6, 9, 12 months go by, they reach their event, but they already are waiting and can't wait to have a binge afterwards. Maybe that is giving up cycling for a few months, you know, eating crap food for ages and non-stop drinking alcohol. And that's the worst thing, because over a big period of time, actually you never get better on the bike. You might achieve your goals, but big period, talking many years, at least 2, 4, maybe even 8 years, actually working with a coach who actually wants you to see those gains over that period of time, is the best way to see those improvements. And that's why I've got athletes who've been with me 5 or 6 years who are still hitting, you know, power bests, achieving stuff that they could only have dreamed about, PBs on Strava and stuff like that. And they're in their 50s and 60s. And that's, you know, counter to what we normally hear about age being restrictive. Now, of course, what I'm going to say to you, though, is if you've heard that, if you want to lose weight, you should be self-disciplined. And that is the pinch of salt to take away from that. If you do really need to lose weight, you're not going to be able to do it if you're constantly eating and drinking. But make sure that you are still enjoying it, because if you're not enjoying the process, I'm going to tell you it's going to be short term too. And that is it. Thank you for bearing with me on this. I hope you've taken away some useful information. I'll be honest, you've probably not liked it, just because it's not the information that you want to hear, but I can guarantee it's the information you need to hear. So I hope you can appreciate that. And if you do, please share this with your friends. If you're on YouTube, in the description, it's gonna be loads of information, the science that I've taken to build this, you know, this resource, links to my other blogs and stuff like that. And if you're on my website, in the blog below will be the same. Like I say, please, please, please share this with your friends, reach out, leave me a comment or a thumbs up or something like that so we can have a chat about your needs. My name is Coach Pav. Thank you so much for tuning in. Have an awesome day.